Hi, this video is about the chemical properties of aldehyde and ketones, and exactly nucleophilic addition of ammonia we are going to see. Ammonia with aldehydes and ketones. So over here, if you see the resonance hybrid, so there are two canonical forms which is given here, carbon with O. So over here, two lone pair electrons. When the electron moves to oxygen, here three lone pair electrons, that makes the carbon to carbocation. I mean oxygen will pull the electron. So always that pull will be there, the permanent pull will be there. So over here, due to the carbonyl compounds present in aldehydes and ketones, these are highly reactive, okay? Because the carbon atom of the carbonyl group is electron deficient, whereas the oxygen atom is an electron rich element. So due to this C double bond O in aldehyde, both aldehyde and ketone, they are highly reactive. And also if you take in aldehyde, so hydrogen is bonded with the carbon atom. So due to the presence of hydrogen atom in aldehyde, again the carbonyl group, I mean the aldehydes are more reactive than ketone because of the hydrogen atom present in it. So this shows, because of this, this gives several different reactions from ketone. So when you move on to nucleophilic addition of ammonia, here it's about the aldehyde. So in aldehyde, again the formaldehyde, when formaldehyde reacts with ammonia, when formaldehyde reacts with ammonia, you will get urotrophin, which is hexamethylene, 6-methylene, CH2-6N4. So hexamethylene tetraamine, which is otherwise known as urotropin. So you will get this, but only with the formaldehyde, ammonia with formaldehyde. But if it is other aldehyde, other aliphatic aldehydes like ethanol, propanol, whatever, any aliphatic aldehyde with ammonia. So over here, the ethereal solution of ammonia, that means the ammonia reacts with any aldehyde in the presence of ether. So this what will happen, the complex will form. So addition of just adding up of ammonia with the aldehyde leads to aldehyde ammonia. So aldehyde group and also the ammonia, I mean the one of the hydrogen binds with OH, oxygen. So aldehyde ammonia you will get, but this is a unstable substance. So what will happen, by warming it, it will lose water molecule, so that it leads to acetaldehyde, that mean aldehyde, okay? Over here the water evolves, I mean the hydrogen from this and the OH evolves as a water molecule. Now with the aromatic aldehyde with NH3, aromatic aldehyde in the sense, over here we are talking about benzaldehyde. So see the reaction carefully. We are using 3 moles of benzaldehyde, 1, 2, 3. So they have displayed like this so that you will understand how the bonding takes place. So 3 moles of benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia like this. So the two hydrogen binds with this oxygen, and same way over here, and these two hydrogens binds with this O. So that means this goes as water, okay? So this goes as water. So 3 moles of water this will lose, so that you will get hydrobenzamide, okay? So that is why they have displayed like this, to understand this structure. So hydrobenzamide you will get. So the overall reaction is, you need 3 moles of benzaldehyde, 2 moles of ammonia to get hydrobenzamide, 1 mole of hydrobenzamide. Yeah, thank you, children.